Okay, do my best to talk us up.
But you are not the masters of your memory.
What are you?
V, listen. I've got this delicate matter. That's why I called you. The number of cyberpsycho attacks in the city is on the rise. Now, that's probably not news to you, but this issue matters to me for a few reasons. There are people who say cyberpsychosis can be treated.
Right.
And I know exactly how that sounds, but I believe even an unproven therapy is still better than a bullet to the brain. If I get a tip about a possible attack, I'll give you a call. Maybe you can investigate before MaxTac hits the scene. But remember, you're not there to execute anybody. Try to incapacitate the attacker, and I'll send someone to pick him up. I hope that's all clear.
Let's just say you're right. So what? Should I just gouge out my optics? Thanks, but no thanks.
You are beyond salvation, but not the children of the future! Life untainted by surgery of the sacrilege! We can yet save them! May the mothers shield their bodies! May the fathers instill their hatred for Crow! But who are those who follow our every step, you ask? Why the titans of entertainment in Alpha Centauri? In their wretchedness, they placate their weary and oppressed masses by putting our laughter, our tears, on full display!
Dexter Deshawn in the flesh. Ample indeed.
Let's roll. Mind if I ask you something right off the bat? Would you rather live in pieces, Mr. Nobody, die ripe, old, and smelling slightly of urine, or go down for all times in a blaze of glory, smelling near like posies, without seeing your 30th? Mr. V?
This some sort of test?
Just a pet topic of mine.
You mean riddles?
No, Mr. V. Ontology. Alright, listen close. Scanning a serious job now. Playing gargantuan compared to smashing up a scav home.
Hang on. I got a question of my own now. Why all this, Dex? Why me? Could have had Jackie or T-Buck sitting here. Could have just done this on comms.
Call me old-fashioned, but I like to look anyone I do biz with in the eye. Had the pleasure of meeting the Jackster in the past, and sweet T-Bug helped this brother out 2 years ago. So here we are. Besides all that, got a special little pre-mission just for you, but we'll get to that.
Let me hear it. What's the job?
There's this prototype tech, a biochip to be precise. Job's to grab it. Simple.
Yeah? Guessing it belongs to a corp.
Mm-hmm. Arasaka. Surely that's no problem.
No problem. Just a death sentence. NC's Arasaka's turf. Nobody fucks with them here.
What can I say, Mr. V? High risk, high reward. First rule of the afterlife. Besides that, I'm no leadhead. Ain't gonna leave no trace for them to follow, because we're gonna do this clean and on the hush-hush. We understand each other.
You work this out? Got a plan?
Two things. First, a conundrum with the Maelstrom boys. Needs active resolving that. Second, a rendezvous. Simple. Client who brought us the job's anxious. She wants to parlay with one of the team.
What's the issue needs resolving with Maelstrom? Got a beef?
Slotting the shard. Got a classic tale for you. Psycho gang doing his thing 2 weeks back. Jumped a Militech convoy. Got away with the gear. Corp don't even know Maelstrom's involved. Now see, convoy was carrying the Flathead, a little combat bot, a prototype. And I need me that bit of high-grade military tech. Because if we don't get that bot, we don't get no soccer chip. And we sure as hell don't get no happily ever after. But don't get excited. It's a single-use toy. Now, I flat-out purchased the damn thing from Maelstrom. Problem is, I did so from a gent went by the name of Brick. I say when, because Brick was the leader. 3 days after we'd sealed our deal, his friend and gangmate, one Simon Randall, aka Royce, plain dropped his ass. Royce is in charge now, and I got no way of knowing if he aims to honor his predecessor's word. To add to this shitstorm, one Meredith Stout of Militech has developed an interest in said convoy.
Who's the prima donna?
Corpo agent, internal affairs. Been skidding around town asking after the convoy as if her life depended on finding it. The one lead she's got zip-tied in her trunk. Stick up her ass ain't growing any shorter, so she must be getting desperate. Be wise to think how you could use that. Of course, to do so, you'll need that frazzled cat's info. Sending it now.
Client, what's her thing? Why she need to meet?
Woman's name's Evelyn Parker. Betting her wasn't easy. Put the word out I was looking for any kind of intel.
Right, and?
Some brothers from Pacifica got back to me. Told me to stop looking. End of convo. Anyway. Our little client insisted on meeting someone with skin in the game. You know, who'll be there for it all. Yours truly will be remote. T-Bug ain't no people person, and Jaggy's only good at some things. I know you know what I mean. Pretty much leaves you.
Think I got everything. Time I got to work.
Well, that's just music to my ears. I'll set up the meet with Miss Parker at Lizzie's bar. Flathead, though, is gonna be all you. One more thing, Mr. V. Quiet life or blaze of glory? Later now.
Dexter, talk to Dex.
Yeah, Cortito's a big deal. Literally a nog.
Guy certainly knows how to protect his biz. Wants to put us on a few small kinks. Prep work, I guess. Before lining us up a big job. There's this combat bot, military prototype. Maelstrom clept it. Then Dex paid to take it off their hands just before the gang goons had a switch up in management.
Right. Heard about that. Royce versus Brick. Hostile takeover.
That sums it up. Dex wants us talking to Royce. Gave the deets of some Militech agent, too, but I don't know how much help she stands to be.
Chingon.
Then there's the other thing. Gotta meet the client who put the job on the table. Evelyn Parker.
You? Well, what's Dex gonna do? Ride around in his limo, chat chicks up on the hollow?
Parker wants to meet someone on the crew. Dex gave me the nod.
He must know what he's doing. So, how you wanna play this? Maelstrom or Parker? What's first?
Parker. I think I ought to see her first. See what she's like, what she's after.
Orale. In that case, I'll hit the All Foods. Put my nose to the ground. Sniff around. Hasta luego.
Here for a pickup. Order number 48.
No, I mean, just check. 48. You sure? That's a whole pack of...
Hello?
How's it going?
We're gonna buy some new iron. A few dozen pounds.
Well, be my fucking guest.
T-Bug sent me. Said you'd have something for me.
You're V, right? She had me hold the demon for you. It should work on any third-gen deck.
Got a Militech power line. Think it'll do.
Solid gear. For a beginner.
Okay. Glad to grab a demon, always.
You could test it now. I have an access point. If you'd like, that is. You might extract some shimsoft or subroutines. Seems worth a try, either way.
Got anything Nova for sale?
If you can afford it, yes.
How's this work? Any punk off the street can waltz in here? Grab some shady running soft?
No, not just any punk. Over the counter, we fix cyber decks. But if you come recommended and you know what you are looking for, I'm sure you will find it.
Thank you.
Got anything tasty and quick?
It's like they say. You either get tasty or you get quick. Here you get full spread. 2-in-1.
Is it just me, or does that burger have a tail?
It's a kid's meal. Kids like surprises.
Life is full of disappointment.
Looking a little put out there, input. Interest you in a frame, BD?
What do you got?
What don't we got? Women and men of your dreams. Synaptic acting A-listers, no washed-up virtue porn boy toys or blow-up dolls here.
Auteur stuff. It'll grip your heart and blow your nerves right out of your body. Pure bit-based ecstasy. That's why people come here.
Clearly know how to sell it.
Not a sales pitch, it's a warning. I'll give you one word. Bespoke. Not for everyone's synapses.
Think you can handle it?
You know what? Maybe another time.
Sure thing, stud.
Reconsidered, huh?
Bespoke? Damn, that sounds promising. I get it, I'm in.
Mm-hmm. Couple of things you need to know first. Severe penalties for any unauthorized recording. No drugs, no groping.
Someone catch your eye? You do not grab them. You find them in the catalog, ask for a BD, and get yourself a box.
I really look that green to you. Like I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Doors open.
Have fun, Input.
Welcome to Lizzie's.
My, what a sweet little face you have. My, what a sweet little face you have.
Evelyn Parker. You know if she's here?
Who's asking?
Big tipper. Generous when I get the answers I'm looking for.
Appreciate the gesture. Truly. But afraid I don't get paid to talk. Opposite, actually.
It's all right, Mateo. Evelyn Parker. I knew it was you as soon as you walked in.
Why not say hello sooner?
I wanted to get a good look at you first.
Why are we meeting here? Any particular reason? Actually, it doesn't seem much like your thing, this place.
Mm-hmm. I'll take that as a compliment. Come on. Know a place we can talk where ears won't prick up to listen. We'll be in the lounge, Mateo. Anyone asks, we're not here.
Know that.
You have trouble accepting compliments?
No, Just think flattery's beneath you. Am I wrong?
Maybe Dex is beneath you. Have you known each other long?
Just started working with him, in fact.
I've heard there are two kinds of fixers. Those with stable crews on long contracts and short leashes. Loyalty and predictability they value above all else. Then there's the other kind. Dex's kind.
Come on. Can't leave that hanging.
Headhunters. They lay their trust elsewhere, not in people, but in a thing. Their intuition. They bet on potential. And if they lose that bet, it's the last mistake they ever make. I'm hoping Dex's intuition has served him well in this case.
Let's cut to the chase. What do you got for me?
Your target. I trust you know what it is.
Relic. Secure your soul trinket. Key tech in the program, actually. We're tangling with Arasaka, making this heist one dangerous, risky motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Arasaka's poured billions into personality transfer technology. But me, I just want the data on this one. The chip is tucked away inside Compeki Plaza, the hotel. You ever been?
You know, just never rolled through that neighborhood.
Damn shame. The fresh they serve is sinfully good. Chef must have made a deal with the devil.
So where's this chip hiding exactly?
In a suite on the top floor. The room's occupied by Yorinobu Arasaka.
Yorinobu Arasaka? He's in town?
Don't you read the scream sheets? The media couldn't get enough of Yori coming to Night City. It was all over the headlines. Anyway, he's heir apparent to the Arasaka Empire. Saburo Arasaka's only surviving son.
What? So Arasaka Jr.'s planning to grab the reins while in Night City?
Only a handful of people in Night City know what the Arasaka's real plans are.
Telling me you're one of them? Look, if you've got any spare aces up your sleeve, now's the time to show them.
Now this should make your prick perk up. Yorinobu recently swiped the chip from an Arasaka laboratory. He's made a deal with Netwatch. Aims to sell it to them. Have you spotted my ace yet, or do I need to spell things out?
Wait, neutral Netwatch is mixed up in this.
Netwatch provides net security for all corporations, and collects eddies in the millions for it. But, in this day and age, everyone's in the game, and no one can afford to be a saint. To win, one has to go all in.
So what's Yorinobu due to walk away with?
Unimportant. You focus on the biochip.
What could cyberspace's watchers and protectors offer him? Intelligence on his enemies?
That doesn't matter in the least. Because you'll make sure the transaction never happens, and I get the chip.
Fine. So no Arasaka security on the device, because Yorinobu whisked it away in secret. Now, where's he hiding it?
Likely in a specialized container. One that mimics an organic neural environment. On the outside, it looks like an ordinary briefcase.
And the case is?
You'll see for yourself soon enough. Provided we're done gossiping about the Arasakas.
Okay, what's next?
Now comes the best part. Follow me. Got something for you. Should help you plan. Brain dance from Compeki Plaza.
How's a brain dance supposed to help? Need facts, not thrills.
Think BDs are only good for fondling virtual tits? Jacking off to in those boxes? No. It can be a very useful tool. Good for analyzing details, human perception, even boosted.
No, don't thank me.
Exactly what you need.
what's on the tape.
Yeah.
Yorinobu's suite. The glorious interior. You'll need to locate the relic yourself. Hope I grabbed enough detail to make that possible.
Hold up. Mean to say you recorded this?
Mm-hmm. BD-REC implant. Why, you object?
Supposed to be Yorinobu's pad on the tape. Means you were inside. You know each other?
How else could I get all this intel? I know him pretty well, actually. We have an arrangement. Strictly business. Suits us both, I think.
Let's see this brain dance.
Judy'll help. She's a Mox, too. Besides, we go back, years. V, this is important.
No,
Judy's always been
cry.
There for me.
Got this, though.
Always helped out.
Mm-hmm, sure.
I trust her.
Sure.
But she's see a Mox, not the latest member of your crew. Try not to forget. So, you'll be a good boy. Tread lightly. And keep that tongue on a leash.
Uh-huh.
Relax. Believe it or not, I'm no stranger to tact. In biz or life.
Hey, there you are.
This is V. He's here for that BD role. And V, this is Judy. Best brain dance editor I know.
Enough already. Gonna make me barf.
Impressive looking setup. Need all this to process brain dances.
Analyzers, sensory SIG amps, acoustic and emotive wave monitors, facial expression translators.
Judy.
All right. Compiled your BDF.
What do you think? Will it do?
Still pretty raw, but yeah, ought to do.
Mm-hmm. V needs to get deep inside. That's most important.
So, let's calibrate. Tune it to him. Believe me, I've dealt with worse. You should see the jig-jig street porn we gotta contend with sometimes.
So, we drop V inside. Let him look, let him rummage around, right?
How about it, V? Raw brain dance. Ever taken a dip before?
What do you mean by raw? How's this differ from the ready-mades?
Huh. Ready-mades, provided they're well-made, should feed you feelings and impressions you'd never have the chance to experience yourself in real space. But it's mass-market shit, so it's pre-crafted, hard-coded, fenced in, and manageable. A raw one? Well, it's more like a virtue enviro. Get to move around, look at things in detail. Editors use those layers to fish for juicier emotes and impulses, then use them to pad the BDs that go to market. Sit down, settle in, and we'll get you going.
Me, it won't hurt.
It won't. Not this time. Now sit still, look at me. Gonna run the analysis soft. Should feel a slight tingling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now let's set the optics and other sensory SIGs. Look smack into these two screens. Pretend it's an eye exam.
Am I gonna have to do this calibration dance every time?
Not necessarily, but it's worth the wait. Give me 2 more minutes and you'll see exactly what BD analysis is capable of. One more sec. Need to get the pain receptor limiters in. Okay. All set.
I need to test your profile first. Tossing in a sample BD. You can use it to get to know the editor. Now let me see. Where could we...
Can't he just use my recording? Why are we wasting time?
So we don't risk our necks? Besides, won't take a sec. Got something here. Should be perfect.
Boot it up.
Mm-hmm. Let me give you the tailored version first, as you get your bearings, then we'll jump into editing. Be diving in 3, 2, 1.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
And remember, everything on full blast. They'll spot us extra for a wicked adrenaline high. Okay, on you go.
Down, everybody! On the ground! I want to see you kissing the flooring! Muddy! Now, or I will fucking drop you, I swear to God! Whoa! Yeah! Hey! Now! Before I blow your fucking head off!
Ah! Slow, deep breaths. Your cortisol and adrenaline spiked, but the soft activated your hormone blockers. Nothing happened. You're alive and well.
That flash of intense shock. I can still feel it, I remember. Fuck, that last second. Could have warned me how much it hurts to die.
Trust me, real death hurts much, much more.
Not so sure about that.
You'll be fine. Got everything set up? Let's switch over to editing mode. Sever the link to the BD Roller's sensory array, you'll be able to look around freely. Whole scene's yours. Full cam control and analysis mode, so move around, zoom in and out, whatever else you come up with. Think of it as your own little sandbox. So, analysis mode, you control playback, can even pause when you feel the need. Then you use the editor console to unpause. Try it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out, and we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
Dream as hell, right? Well, that's not all. You can speed things up or rewind, whatever you like. Give it a try. Rewind. Roll it back to the top.
That's...
All good, neat. Now try fast forwarding a bit.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd.
Okay. You can also reset the recording. That'll take you right back to the beginning. Try it. Now for some fun. This here's why you came in the first place. In analysis mode, you get to view and even scan details of the enviro recorded by the BD Roller. Focus on the heat. The gun this gonk gets from his buddy at the beginning. Now scan it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get cr- You go in, snatch the cash, yeah. Thing on full blast. The monster for a wicked adrenaline high.
Okay, right here. Excellent. Let's move on. Now, heads up. In analysis mode, you can ferret out background noise and conversations if the roller got close enough. This tech records everything, every little detail, even the sights and sounds the roller was never aware of. To see the sources of the recorded sensory signals, switch to the audio layer in the editor. Go ahead and try that now. Okay, good. Now you should see several sound signatures in the store. Choose one and hone in on it.
Okay, fuck! On you go!
Ah, little shitheads! Go restock. I'll take the register. How about you suck a bag of dicks, eh?
So, any thoughts?
Unbelievable. Seriously, like what's happening right next to me.
Yeah, it's how BD recording implants work. They pick up everything, all the elements in the background. Then an editor tweaks them, makes them pop. Keep playing with the sound, explore it a bit. We'll move on when you get bored.
Go restock. I'll take the register. How about you suck a bag of dicks,
okay? We have a deal today on two flavors. Cuddy and Serpentine.
Everybody!
Sometimes you can analyze extra layers in the raw, stuff the roller's cyberware picked up.
Like what?
Ev's got Kiroshi optics that grab infrared, meaning you should be able to grab heat signatures from her recording.
Huh. Hella nice.
Now let's wait till the guy punches out the gonk at the counter.
On the ground! Wanna see you kissing the flooring! Money!
Scanning works on peeps, too. Walk up to the wounded chick. Try scanning her. All right, next thing. Scroll forward to the part where our artist gets a lead injection.
Now, or I will fucking drop you! I swear to God! Whoa, you're paying now!
See that? They shot him and he never saw it coming. But you will. Here it comes. My favorite part of the game. See the blinking thing over the entrance? Surveillance cam. Must have caught our shooter. You'll see in a sec. Cam feeds to the screen behind the clerk. Roll back to where the screen's in the kids' field of vision, then scan it. Chumba shot him. Probably planned to all along. Must have got a nice slice of cred on the black market for a BD like this. BD freaks are ready to pay a preem for a real flatline. Anyway, if you've seen enough, you can exit.
Bad most of the BDs we do here are only good for flogging the log. Anyway, you ready to do this? Look at your wreck?
No way. Let's take a break. Still feel like that kid when... Oh, yeah. Think I'm done.
V, there's no time. Get it together, please.
Okay. Okay. Go ahead. Just need T-Bug to link in.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Who?
Running for my crew, security specialist. She'll tell me what to look for while we analyze. No problem, I hope.
Actually, it is a problem. Not what we agreed, Ev.
Judy, T-Bug's a professional, discreet to a fault. You can trust her.
Why? 'Cause you say so?
Please, Judy. I'd never expose you to any danger. You know that.
Okay, V. Call T-Bug and we'll dive in.
Hey, V. What's happening?
Bug, listen. I got some useful footage from Compeki Plaza. It's a brain dance.
Cunt Peggy.
Oh, thought as much.
Someone there with you?
Judy and Evelyn, they're chill. They're helping me work through this BD.
Uh-huh. All right. You gonna tell me what this is about?
Listen, need your help. Got no clue what to look for once I'm in.
All right, see if I can walk you through it. Jacking into your tech now. You've got to give me access. Opening port 1779. Secure protocol? Good, I'm going in. Should be getting my requests now.
Got it. You ready?
A millisec. Okay, connection confirmed. Now some quick tip ice and we're clear. Ready to dance.
Fire up, Judy.
All right, V, eyes open. Gotta find out where Yurinobu's keeping the relic.
You look like a cut of fuckable meat, are you?
Evelyn, she... I felt her fear. Sure got it under control quick, too.
I said no.
They'll have my head for this.
Then, you shall perish for a good cause.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute.
Listen in on that conversation, V. Could be something important.
Finish.
We shall see soon enough. My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change and he'll live forever. In his tiny, frozen bubble. We'll listen to this. Saburo is an adult despot, utterly removed from reality. Stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists. Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years. I am quite sure we want now. That's it. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with your father. He's taken a particular interest in this project. He can certainly explain the risks.
My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard. Who thinks nothing will change, and he'll live forever in his tiny, frozen bubble.
I should not even be listening to such things.
We'll listen to this. Saburo is an adult despot, utterly removed from reality. Stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists. Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years. I am quite sure we want now.
Read the documentation carefully. The relic requires specific storage conditions. You must provide them.
Heard that? Relic docs gotta be around here somewhere. Look for them. Drone. Ventilation and cooling? Servers. Gotta be. Fancy doodads in here need to be controlled.
Thank you.
Sorry to make you wait. Business. Can't be stupid.
It wasn't long. Not even long enough for me to grow bored. Is everything all right? You seem tense.
Edgy.
A moment. It will pass.
I can get to work on that. Just one condition.
You wish to make demands of me?
Only one. Focus on me. Oh, got any candy left? Steph was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom. Nightstand.
I've got an idea. Be right back.
Very nice. But come here already.
Just a sec. Looking for the perfect thing. Ah, you'll like this.
What love is, until you've learned the meaning of the blue belonging in the girl's weakness.
Steph was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom, nightstand.
I've got an idea. Be right back. Just a sec. Looking for the perfect thing. Ah, you'll like this.
What love is, until you've learned the meaning.
Manual details a special temp-controlled container. Relic needs to be kept real cool.
So, chip's gotta stay in the freezer.
Yep, could damage it otherwise. Okay, switch on thermal layer detection in the editor. Should be easier to spot where Yorinobu's keeping the chip.
For this.
Then, you shall perish for a good cause.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to my...
Oh, Donaghy's. Looks like Mr. Arasaka had something to celebrate. Really think you'll find the chip in there? No way. Temp's too low. Could fluctuate. Nice try, though. Grab the heat sig. Matches the spec in the docks.
Yorinobu's got the case here. Guaranteed.
Mm-hmm. We got it. Good work. Looks like we got everything we need. Quit out of the editor.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with your father.
Get everything you need?
Yep, that'll do. Thanks, Judy. We got it. Later, T-Bug.
Nice work today. See you soon.
I'll wipe the cache and your data. You were never here. Put it on Ev's tab. Portable device for handling VDs. I already uploaded your calibration settings. Not as sophisticated as what we got here, but should do the trick.
And it keeps you out of harm's way. Clever.
Speaking of harm's way, know what I see looking at you? Walking, talking corpses.
We needed that recording, Judy. The BD practically does our job for us.
The BD will be the death of us. Seriously.
If Arasaka finds out you have it, you're dead. I'm dead.
Judy, relax. Nobody will ever know.
Evelyn, please. No shortcuts. You go that route, City'll always win. So be careful.
Of course I will be. Besides, we'll talk in a bit. Let's walk. Well, what do you think?
You're not worried? Arasaka will flag and screen anyone who's had dealings with Yorinobu.
Oh, they'll have a long list then. Packed full of big names. Much bigger than mine. You tell me who they check first. Corpo hotshots and cutthroats? Or a little bedroom plaything like me?
I think I see how you know so much about Yorinobu.
It's simple. Men like pillow talk a bit too much.
So it's just about the sex?
Biz. And biz only.
You sure Yorinobu doesn't expect this kind of move from you?
He's got no idea. Trust me. He's too busy with Netwatch to give me that kind of attention. Besides, even if some suspicion takes root in his mind, it shouldn't matter. He won't react in time. And that's something you'll handle, right?
Intel on Yorinobu, the chip, the BD from Compeki. Winds are right. Plan's perfect. Job like this comes one in a million.
Thanks. Now the punchline, please.
Just sounds too good to be true. What's the catch?
Cold feet. Are you looking to get out of it?
I want to know if you're really in control here. You're not sending me into the sort of shit I can't wait out of.
V, I have zero reasons to haze you. We're in this together. Really. Trust me that I got this.
So, what now?
V, do this job for me. I mean me alone. No splitting the payout with anyone else. No middlemen. No Dex. V?
You want to fuck over our fixer? I knew something was up.
Dex is a middleman. And a useless one at this point.
Evelyn, you don't mess with fixers. That's the one rule every merc in this city knows, and actually follows.
But if we're smart...
Doesn't matter.
Mistake like that'll cost you your rep. And without a rep, you're nobody. You sure you want to do this?
Better ask yourself that question. Do you want to spend the rest of your days blasting scavs? Or become a legend overnight? Your choice.
If I agree, there'll be hell to pay, for sure.
I know. Whatever you decide, it stays between us. I can offer 50%. Eddie's enough to do whatever the hell you like.
I'll be finished. Dex won't forgive a dirt move like this.
Dex isn't the only fixer in town. But my offer's the only one you'll ever get.
Let me think about it.
Mm-hmm. If you need me, call. I'll send you my number.
Okay.
Good luck. Now go. I need a few words with Judy.
How things looking, Mr. V?
Turns out Evelyn's recording from Compeki was worth our time.
Beautiful. T-Bug already called. Said she's working her magic. And the flathead?
Nothing yet. On it now.
T-Bug says no chance of that chip without that bot. To work then, Mr. V.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll see ya.
I'm off the clock, hon. Eye of the tiger, babe. Thank you.
problem?
Telling me how you got this number.
No more than your number. Heard you misplaced a convoy.
You shut him up! Spill what you know. Don't make me wait.
Nuh-uh. Not on the horn. Let's meet. Cut a deal.
A deal? Fine. First exit off Skyline, driving towards the NID. Storm channel under the overpass. Meet you there.
オービタルエアは快適な宇宙の旅をお届けします。ご旅行の際はぜひオービタルエアを選びます。